The Catholic Women Association that prepares and serves food at events like funerals, burials, and weddings are breadwinners in their families, but they observe that little support is being given to them to expand their businesses.
We need transport for transporting us to where the service is and bringing us back. And we need oven because we have here many occasions like wedding, traditional marriage, there is also graduation ceremony.
They are calling on the leadership of Gulu City to find alternative ways of supporting informal women-led businesses.
When the year is ending, provide money to the members. Also, when we come back from the work, we provide 10,000 per person.
Besides preparing food at functions, these women have also ventured into preparing groundnut paste, locally known as Odi. They are also making beads and baskets.
All of us has got different training. So we thought of training the women the best way, the regional way of making the paste, so that we can also generate income. Our intention is to go even at the level of export, if possible, if we are supported.
The Northern Uganda Women Network for Business Development and Outbox have taken up the initiative of mobilizing the women groups running informal businesses in order to link them up to finding opportunities.
At the end of the day, a woman must have money. A woman must have their savings. A woman must be able to take care of their families, because these women, they take care of their families. They pay school fees. They need money for hospital. They need money for food at home. They need money for their entire welfare.
Through NUEBIS, the National Security Social Fund, NSSF, has made this women group in Gulu City. NSSF has piqued interest in supporting the Catholic Women Association and the Islamic Subra Women Group.
We've had several engagements with NSSF to have them come today and see what the women are doing for themselves. And after this engagement, I am happy and excited that because they have seen what the women have done, what the women are doing for themselves, they are coming on board to help out, to support their businesses, to train them to grow.
The Gulu City Mayor Alfred Okwonga has also pledged to lobby for funds to support these women-led businesses.
I'm appealing for all the partners to really go and support groups which are organized like this. We are lobbying together as the leaders of Gulu City so that we support such groups that are doing viable economic activities so that they can grow. What I've seen, they have a lot of gaps in area of transport, quality utensils, and the machines that they use for making their uniforms.
More women across Northern Uganda are taking up the family leadership role, as men spend a lot of time in trading centers, drinking alcohol, and sports betting. Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu.